Hello students, today we are going to see the permeability experiment. So there are two parts of permeability. One is constant head permeability test and second one is falling head permeability test. Constant head permeability test is performed on more permeable soil. Falling head permeability test performed on the less permeable soil. So today we are going to see the constant head permeability test, and for that we have taken the sand sample. The sample preparation or mold preparation for both the constant head permeability test and falling head permeability test will remain same. This mold consisting of three parts. The base part is, this is the base of this particular mold, which contains porous stone at the bottom. Then there is a washer and we can see there is an outlet. Okay. Then this is the mold, okay, that we have to place on the base plate likewise. Okay. And we have to make it tight using this particular scale washer. So using nut and bolt arrangement, we have to make it tight. So first of all, we will make this particular mold. We will attach this particular mold to the base plate like this, and we have to make it tight. Before placing the soil sample, we have to place the filter paper at the bottom, okay, to avoid the passage of solid particles through the porous stone. Then we are going to pour this particular sand sample inside of this particular mold. Then at the top we have to place the filter paper as well as porous stone. It should be like this. Next to that, the third part is the cap. So again there is a one washer to the cap to avoid the seepage or leakage of water through the cap. So we are going to connect this particular cap. It should be like this. Then again we have to make it tight using this nut and bolt arrangement. Uniformly. see the next part of this particular permeability. So this is the constant overhead tank through which we are penetrating the water through the soil sample, and through the outlet we are going to collect. Before that, we have to make sure that the soil sample is fully saturated. So how to fully saturate this soil sample? So there is a one concept, that is back saturation. What we have to do, we have to connect this particular water pipe at the outlet, and then there is a one valve. This valve is called as an air release valve, so that the all the air which is present inside that particular soil sample will get escape out through this air release valve. So now water has started to percolate in the upward direction. So when water moves in the upward direction, so all the air which is present inside that particular sand sample will get escape out through this air release valve or through the inlet. Once we able to remove all the air from the soil, we will close this and we will start to allow the flow of water from the inlet. Now we will wait. Okay, water will come off from this particular air release valve, and then we will stop it. Now you can see, we will stop this flow of water, and now you can see all the air which is removed from this soil sample. Now we will connect this particular again. There will be chances of some air which will be come out of this. You can see air is coming out of, so we will stop this and we will start to flow the water. Okay, so there is a constant flow of water through this particular mold, and once constant flow starts, we are going to take a reading. Make sure that, so there is one formula, that is QS upon HAG. So H is the constant head. You can see water level is at the total head is 1 meter, that is 100 centimeter. Total head is there, and under that particular head, water is getting flowed through this particular mold. Now we will take a reading. So we will take a 3 readings for 30 seconds, for 45 seconds, and for 1 minute. So I will start the stopwatch. So first of all, we will take a reading for 30 seconds. So this is quantity of water collected in this particular cylinder, and time T is, so for first reading, time T is 30 seconds. So I will start it. We got, it is 275 ml for 30 seconds. So again we will take a second reading for 45 seconds. I will reset this stopwatch, and again I will start for 45 seconds. 45 seconds, we can see it is 410 mm. Okay. So, we will see for 1 minute. We will take a third observation for 1 minute. Start. So for 1 minute, it is approximately 545 mm. So we have taken 3 observations, so we can able to find out the permeability using constant head permeability test. So that is about the constant head permeability test. If we are looking after the falling head permeability test, you can see there is a stand pipes. Okay. So we are going to connect this particular mold to this particular stand pipes. As in the case of less permeable soil, the quantity of water which is getting percolated to the soil sample is very less. So that we are going to measure the fall of water in the stand pipe. We are not able to collect the water through the outlet. Now in the case of constant head permeability test, we can able to collect the water through the outlet. But in case of falling head permeability test, we cannot able to collect the water through outlet. So we are going to measure the head fall in the stand pipes.